Hi, welcome back. This is the fourth week, and by now you should be really encoding your text at very high speed and enjoying also doing it. So this week we will give you some extra feature to make extra special your encoding. And particularly we will discuss about indexing and how to encode name of people, dates and things like that in order to make them indexable and in order to collect them for creating online indexing. To do that, we need to talk about how is done the indexing and what is indexing. Indexing is the basic commodities of all edition. And you may want to have index of name, of place, of dates, of chapters, of figures, of manuscripts, etc., etc. And there is two ways for doing an index. Okay, the first one is to do it by hand. So you have your text somewhere and you take a piece of paper or another computer and you start typing down. Every time you find something you want to put on an index, you type it down. So you create by hand your index. What is the problem with that? The problem is that it may be not accurate, you may forget something, it may be inconsistent, and sometimes when you have added all the page number, all the references, you add something and everything, you have to start again because the page, the structure has been changed and you cannot do it anymore. The other possibility is doing automatically. Many software, including your favorite word processor, offer you a way for generating index automatically, meaning that you have to add some invisible, normally, codes inside your text, and that enables then the software to automatically generate the index. If you change something, it's automatically updated. So what is the problem with this approach? The problem is that sometimes, particularly if you use a word processor, the codes are invisible and you risk to mingle with them. They're not very easy to manage. And there is lots of bugs, so let me tell you that. So that is, a smarter way of doing it, because everything that you can ask a computer to do automatically for you is better if you do it automatically. How do you do an index? But first of all, again, and let me go back to this point again, you need analysis, you need modeling, because names of people or places or dates that you find in your files, sometimes they just need to be adjusted a little bit. You need, for instance, when you find the name of a person, make sure that you record always the surname first, or the comma, and all the name and middle name afterwards. For a date, you may want to standardize the date to a Gregorian calendar, or to translate Julian to Gregorian. And for places, it's also a problem because sometimes they change name. In fact, it's very important to remember that a name of a person is not a person. People change name, particularly women tend to change name a lot during their life. And a name of a place is not always the same. Cities, places change name all the time. And a date is not a moment in time. It's just a representation, a standardized representation of a moment in time. It's not the same thing. So a little bit of modeling is very important at the beginning. Now, the TI has several ways for doing that, and you will learn some of the most used one, the most easy one as well. What you need to do is whenever you want to add something to your index at the end, you need to add, guess what, an element. And also to normalize the name or the date or whatever you want to index in the end in with an attribute normally or some way of normalization. We shall see now how to do name of people and places.